How to unpack and handle the FVR screw compressor. Tools. Cutter. 14mm fixed range. 24mm fixed range. 41mm fixed range. 36mm fixed range. Two of 30mm fixed ranges. Screw gun or ratchet. 13mm socket. 24mm socket. Phillips screwdriver. Torque wrench. Pliers. Grease for O-rings or oil. Crane with suitable lifting equipment or forklift truck. Personal protective equipment. Safety helmet. Protective glasses. Protective gloves. Safety shoes. Attention! Keep and read the instructions manual carefully and always respect the safety warnings indicated. How to unpack the compressor. Check the label on the compressor's packing and make sure it corresponds to what's indicated on the packing list. Check the condition of the packaging to verify that no damage has occurred during the transport and that it's therefore intact. With a cutter, cut and remove the straps from the packaging. Lift the box and remove it to reveal the compressor. How to check the supply status of the compressor? Check that the serial number shown on the packaging label corresponds to the serial number shown on the compressor label. Check that all the accessories contained in the packaging correspond to what's indicated on the packaging list. The standard supply includes the oil circuit kit supplied separately in a cardboard box and containing one oil assembly filter. Two of 22mm ODS fittings, two Teflon rings, two O-rings, two of 22mm rotolock ODS fittings, one flow switch, two of 22mm rotolock ODS fittings, two Teflon rings, one of 22mm ODS solenoid valve, one 230V AC 50 or 60 Hz coil, one coil connector, one 22mm ODS liquid sight glass. If you have a compressor model 370, 430, 460 or 540, there will only be the following: one 22mm ODS solenoid valve, one 230V AC 50 or 60 Hz coil, one coil connector. Check that the coils are fitted on the compressor and, using a Phillips screwdriver or a screw gun, open the junction box and check that it contains exhaust temperature probe, spare gasket kit for the valves, vibration damper support kit, two coil connectors, economizers inlet, kit for electrical connection, proven module with terminal block. Handling the compressor. Using a 14mm wrench, check that the compressor contains pressurized nitrogen by unscrewing the pressure fitting cap. Having performed the check, carefully close the pressure fitting cap again. Attention! The compressors are supplied with a protective charge of nitrogen 0.5 to 1 bar above atmospheric pressure to prevent air from entering them. Risk of damage to the eyes and skin? Always wear safety goggles. Do not open the connectors before the internal pressure is released. Using a screw gun, unscrew and remove the screws, securing the compressor to the pallet. If a screw gun is not available, use a ratchet with a 13mm socket. Attention, do not use steel traps or cables to move the compressors and do not pass them underneath it. These may cause damage and ruin the paint. To move the compressor, it is necessary to use a crane equipped with a suitable lifting and handling equipment. If a crane is not available, use a forklift or a suitable lifting tool. For handling operations, use the anchor points on the compressor. Make sure that the compressor does not hit the valves, the electrical components, and the piping is general. This could include damage to the compressor. How to position the compressor? Attention! The compressor must always be securely fastened to a frame capable of withstanding the static and dynamic forces generated by it. Take the package containing the vibration damper support kit and check that it contains 4 rubber vibration damper supports, 4 screws, 4 washers, 4 rubber washers, 4 self-locking nuts. Place the vibration damper support in the top part of the base and position the compressor. Take the bolt and insert the rubber washer. Insert the bolt from the lower side of the base upwards. In the top part, insert the washer and then the self-locking nut. Using a ratchet with a 24mm socket and a second 24mm fixed wrench, secure the vibration damper support by carefully fastening everything. Finish tightening with a torque wrench with a 24mm socket set to 30Nm. Follow the same procedure to install the other 3 vibration damper support. Pipe welding preparation phase. Using a 14mm wrench, check that there is no nitrogen in the compressor by unscrewing the pressure fitting cap. Having performed the check, carefully close the pressure fitting cap again. Attention! Before welding the piping and starting the compressor, remove the sealing disc under the protective flange supplied by Frascold as a protection. To remove the disc, disassemble the discharge valve by unscrewing all the screws, securing it, using a screw gun with a 24mm socket. Remove the valve and remove the sealing disc. At this point, refit the protective flange. Oil circuit kit assembly. Before installing the oil circuit kit, take the oil filter assembly and check the direction of the flow following the arrows on it. Install all the components according to their direction indicated. Using a pair of pliers, remove the protective caps. Take the two 22mm ODS fittings and insert a Teflon ring and an O-ring on each of them. Applying a light coat of special oil or grease beforehand. Once the two gaskets are in place, using a 41mm fixed wrench, tighten the two fittings on the two ends of the oil filter. Take the two 22mm Rotolock ODS fittings and screw them into the two newly positioned fittings. using a 41 fixed wrench and a 36mm fixed wrench. Take the flow switch assembly, remove the protective caps and insert the two Teflon rings. Before assembling, always check the installation direction indicated by the arrow, and then fit the two 22mm rotolock ODS fittings. On the two ends using the two 30mm fixed wrenches. At this point, take the 22mm ODS solenoid valve and always check the direction of installation first. Remove the protective caps. Finally, take the 22mm ODS liquid sight glass assembly and, as before, remove the protective caps. Carefully weld all the components to finish assembling the oil circuit kit. Remove the solenoid cap and remove the label, insert the 250V AC 50-60Hz coil and position the connector with its gasket. Using a Phillips screwdriver, carefully tighten the screw to secure everything. If you like this video, subscribe to the channel and discover all Frascold's video trainings. Frascold, blue is better.